Look who's back from vacation. Welcome back, Richard.
Thank you, Pam. How are you?
I'm very well. You are joining us from the 680 News Business Center. Let's start with another ominous sign for the print journalism industry. We're used to hearing about this.
Yeah, it's not good. And it's not good, Pam, for the many people I see on the subway and the bus reading these papers every day. It's the StarMetro. You know those free papers they give away? There's soon going to be no more. Toronto Star and its parent company, Torstar Communications, announcing today that they're going to publish the final StarMetro papers on the 20th of December. Come December 20th, those free papers are going to be no more. So this affects those papers here in Toronto as well as in Vancouver, Edmonton, and Calgary. A spokesperson from Torstar telling me today that they're going digital only because commuter readers, they say, are, quote, using their smartphones, laptops, tablets to access their news on the way to and from work. And I suppose they're picking up those papers a lot less. This will result in 73 job losses. However, the Star as well, according to an internal memo obtained by 680 News and City News, will open new bureaus in Vancouver, Edmonton, Calgary, and Halifax. Sources tell me they will hire back a number of laid-off people to work in those bureaus. But as you say, not good for the industry. And, you know, I know a lot of people like to do the crosswords in those papers on the way to work, Pam.
Including me.
See, there you go. You know, it's something to pass the time, actually, as opposed to going on your phone when you're traveling to work. And unfortunately, we're going to lose that.
Well, I have to admit that we continue to get the Star at home, and I do like getting it. But I've got to confess that more times than not, it winds up unopened in the recycling.
I know. It's still good to support journalism in all kinds, though. So I will not admonish you one bit for signing up for the Star, Pam.
So tell me about this strike. A strike has shut down the country's largest rail network. And that has some pretty serious business implications.
It could have parts of the Canadian economy, shall we say, going off the rails, Pam. CN rail workers hitting the picket lines today. The union says the main issues are surrounding drug benefits, time off, and remote-controlled train operations, which they're doing now. They're moving trains remotely without people on them at times. Wage is not in dispute here. It's a big issue for the grain companies in Canada, the farmers, the miners, and the oil producers. They need rail to get their products to and from market. In many cases, they have no alternative. The threat of a strike has already impacted grain companies. They have cut back on orders. Foreign companies have cut back on orders to avoid paying contract extension fees. So all this could take a toll on the economy, Pam, depending on how long that CN strike chugs along for.
That will go on for some time, I can imagine.
Could do. We'll keep an eye on it.
Switching to the coffee biz now, analysts say a recent policy change by Starbucks could be backfiring.
It used to be the case you couldn't use a bathroom in Starbucks or couldn't sit at a table unless you bought something first. The company changed that back in May of 2018 after two black men were arrested in one of the company's U.S. locations for waiting for a friend. It was a bad PR move for the company. They changed the policy. Since doing that, though, since opening the bathroom doors to the public, there's been a 6.8% drop-off in store attendance per month relative to nearby coffee shops, according to a new study from the University of Texas and Boston College. Researchers say when people come in just to use the bathrooms and the tables, it results in others finding the bathrooms dirty and the tables crowded, and therefore they buy perhaps less coffee. Pam, Starbucks disputes these findings. They contend that business has been booming, but it makes sense maybe that, you know, when you have everyone coming in, that maybe it's not as an inviting atmosphere. Who knows?
I guess I can see their point, but at the same time, doesn't it bug you when you see that sign on a door? Going into a Tim Hortons, it's like, I am a customer. Maybe I'm not a customer just this minute, but
I've
paid
spent
you
enough
lots
here.
Of money, so I get to use your bathroom.
If only you knew how much we've spent on double doubles over the years, you'd let me in.
Exactly. So we always end this chat with a look at gas prices. Will we be seeing any change at the pumps tonight, Richard?
No change tonight, Pam. Hold tight, because stay with us just after 6:30. Remember Marie Kondo, the organizing expert? People are calling her a hypocrite tonight. We're going to look at the reasons why coming up after 6:30.
All right. Thanks so much. We'll check in with you again in the next hour.
Thanks, Pam.